Axel. Number three, or actually number four, Kamara Slaughter. Number 10, Isaiah Tolbert. And number 32, Kayla Jenkins.
Oh, WVC! showed up, sat down for his game and left.
You already know that the First National Bank is your real community bank, but have you met our people? It's the people inside that make us a community bank. We live here. We work here. We're your neighbors and your friends. When you bank with us, your money is reinvested in your community. At the First National Bank, our customers are more than an account number. People are the reason for this community. We're your hometown bank, serving the area since 1906. We are the First National Bank, where our people make the difference. Come see us today. Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Robinson. Before coming to Senior Enrichment Center, I was so depressed that I couldn't get out of bed. That all changed once I started seeing Danielle, the social worker, and Melanie, the nurse. They have been so kind and they truly care about my health. They have helped me to be able to go out and have shown me the importance of how to deal with my problems in a more constructive way. I think anyone who is experiencing grief, depression, anxiety, or isolation can benefit from this program. The Senior Enrichment Center has changed my life.
The Faulkner Automotive in Mount Carmel, Illinois has an outstanding service department. With free pickup and delivery, we'll make sure your vehicle runs perfectly at an affordable price. Come see us today or view our service specials at stevefaulknerautomotive.com.
News Channel 15, winner of the Intercollegiate Broadcasting System Award for the nation's best community college TV station.
Watch.
Bengals.
New year, new style. Timberlake Furniture is kicking off the new year with the biggest sale to date. Whether it's a new mattress, cozy sofa, large dining set, or a statement piece that steals the show, Timberlake Furniture has it all. And with this sale's exclusive discounts, it's easier than ever to achieve your dream space. Make your house feel like home and stop by Timberlake Furniture.
Oh, my God.
Wilmot.
Thank you.
got 20 assists, 20 got 10 total. Burton had the long shooting.
You already know that the First National Bank is your real community bank, but have you met our people? It's the people inside that make us a community bank. We live here. We work here. We're your neighbors and your friends. When you bank with us, your money is reinvested in your community. At the First National Bank, our customers are more than an account number. People are the reason for this.
Before coming to Senior Enrichment Center, I was so depressed that I couldn't get out of bed. That all changed once I started seeing Danielle, the social worker, and Melanie, the nurse. They have been so kind and they truly care about my health. They have helped me to be able to go out and have shown me the importance of how to deal with my problems in a more constructive way. I think anyone who is experiencing grief, depression, anxiety, or isolation can benefit from this program. The Senior Enrichment Center has changed my life.
New year, new style. Timberlake Furniture is kicking off the new year with the biggest sale to date. Whether it's a new mattress, cozy sofa, large dining set, or a statement piece that steals the show, Timberlake Furniture has it all. And with this sale's exclusive discounts, it's easier than ever to achieve your dream space. Make your house feel like home and stop by Timberlake Furniture to explore 5 acres of inspiration.
College doesn't have to start at an expensive school far away. You can save money and be close to home at Wabash Valley College. Many careers only require a 2-year degree or certificate. Or get your general education classes out of the way and transfer to a 4-year school. Wabash Valley College has programs in high-demand careers such as physical therapy assistant, advanced manufacturing, marketing, business management, nursing, and radio television. To find out more about Wabash Valley College, go to iecc.edu/WVC.
You already know that the First National Bank is your real community bank, but have you met our people? It's the people inside that make us a community bank. We live here. We work here. We're your neighbors and your friends. When you bank with us, your money is reinvested in your community. At the First National Bank, our customers are more than an account number. People are the reason for this community. We're your hometown bank, serving the area since 1906. We are the First National Bank, where our people make the difference. Come see us today. Equal housing lender, member.
Faulkner Automotive in Mount Carmel, Illinois has an outstanding service department. With free pickup and delivery, we'll make sure your vehicle runs perfectly at an affordable price. Come see us today or view our service specials at stevefaulknerautomotive.com.
News Channel 15, winner of the Intercollegiate Broadcasting System Award for the nation's best community college TV station.
Jump that, jump that, jump that, and boy, jump that, jump that. They just smell like 2 or 3 weeks out of the country.
talking about the help on the bench line.
Yeah.
You already know that the First National Bank is your real community bank, but have you met our people? It's the people inside that make us a community bank. We live here. We work here. We're your neighbors and your friends. When you bank with us, your money is reinvested in your community. At the First National Bank, our customers are more than an account number. People are the reason for this community. We're your hometown bank, serving the area since 1906. We are the First National Bank, where our people make the difference. Come see us today. Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Steve Faulkner Automotive in Mount Carmel, Illinois has an outstanding service department. With free pickup and delivery, we'll make sure your vehicle runs perfectly at an affordable price. Come see us today or view our service specials at stevefaulknerautomotive.com.
News Channel 15, winner of the Intercollegiate Broadcasting System Award for the nation's best community college TV station.
You already know that the First National Bank is your real community bank, but have you met our people? It's the people inside that make us a community bank. We live here. We work here. We're your neighbors and your friends. When you bank with us, your money is reinvested in your community. At the First National Bank, our customers are more than an account number. People are the reason for this community. We're your hometown bank, serving the area since 1906. We are the First National Bank, where our people make the difference. Come see us today. Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
There's a lot of things that you can do to help and reduce your heating bills over the wintertime. Open the draperies in the house. Let the sun warm the interior of your home during the day. That helps reduce some of that heating load during the day. Consider installing programmable thermostats. You know, you can drop the temperature down while you're not there, or in the evening times when you're asleep, make the house a little cooler, and then have those programmable thermostats bring the temperature up at the times you're actually in the home, not away.
Before coming to Senior Enrichment Center, I was so depressed that I couldn't get out of bed. That all changed once I started seeing Danielle, the social worker, and Melanie, the nurse. They have been so kind and they truly care about my health. They have helped me to be able to go out and have shown me the importance of...
Well, sorry about that for those of you on 89.1. The Bash had some technical difficulties there for a second, but we're back still here at halftime. Both teams now out on the court to warm up here at the Spencer Sports Center. Zach Reynolds, Austin Harrelson with you here. Kaskaskia with a 6-point, 41-35 lead over the Warriors. As of right now, we've been talking about it. Unfortunately, Austin got cut off there for a second. Just talking about... really the two ways you have to play. You want to help a lot on the big man that's killing you right now, but you can't leave this really good three-point shooting team open. And that's, I'm sure, you know, that's what Coach Terrence McGee has been talking about with him all halftime. That's what he gets paid to do, is find the in-between area that works out for Wabash Valley. And like I mentioned, they showed that last week against Lincoln Trail, that they can make those adjustments. Now, you know, here with a couple minutes left in the halftime, we're going to get into just seeing if they can do it again.
Yeah. And I think that, you know, looking at situations like that, you know, how the attitude in two second halves has been changing for this team, that's something that we haven't seen a lot of. Like, I know for a fact last year, that's not something that we really saw a whole lot of. And, you know, and so, you know, props to Terrence McGee. You know, first year here, this team, you know, they brought in an entire new team outside of Brandon Razor Moore. And I think that, you know, I think Terrence McGee's done a great job so far this year, and you got to give him a lot of credit. And, you know, that's who, you know, when you look at adjustments, for that Lincoln Trail game, you got to give the credit. Obviously, the players are out here doing it, but you got to give the credit to Terrence McGee in it. And, you know, I trust him as a coach to come in into halftime in that locker room and just lay it out. You know, he'll tell them exactly what the issues are. And I don't think that we've had a lot of that here at Wabash, you know, especially, you know, obviously we look at our girls team. They dominate. You know, and this men's team hasn't had that kind of success. But so far this year, this team has looked – this is a great team. This is a team that plays team basketball, like we've talked about. And so with that, I think that this Warriors team only has to just adjust just a couple things in this ball game. And then if you're a Kaskaskia, you just got to clean it up in a half-court setting, and defensively. You know, this Warriors team's taking advantage of some open shots, you know, with Brandon Razor Moore. And then Burton coming off the bench has a nice little stretch from Burton off the bench. And so, and then, you know, and like I said earlier, this team does face the height disadvantage, but they're so athletic, it's like it's not there. You know, it's like that disadvantage hasn't been there. But this Kaskaskia team's gonna feast in the paint, and the Warriors just have to find a way to defend it. And I think that this team, you know, like you said, against Lincoln Trail, they were able to. I think that this team's going to have no problem at least trying to adjust this Kaskaskia team.
I mean, for both sides, like we've been mentioning, all halftime is wrapping up now. Team's about to take the court again. It's a 41-35 game. I mean, both teams really are doing well. They just both have some things that they want to clean up. We'll see who does that better as we're about to get underway in the second half, and that will determine who wins this one. But don't go anywhere, folks. I mean, this one's going to be great all the way to the end.
Oh, absolutely.
It always is in this conference. But again, right here with a 14-2 team in Kaskaskia, a 9-3 team in Wabash Valley, and Wabash Valley with the ball to start the second half. Razor Moore over the logo, swings left side. Daniel Robinson, the point guard, with it. Letting things develop. 20 on the shot clock. Back to Razor Moore up top. He'll dribble towards the left side, now steps it back out. 10 on the shot clock, Razor Moore drives in, cuts to the paint, goes up at the left block, and it rolls in. Using the finger roll that time, Wabash Valley scores first in the second half.
That's another thing, they got to get this guy going as he started to do it towards the end of the first half.
And that one almost taken away. Vassar still with it on the left side there for Kaskaskia. He'll go around a screen from Hodges. He'll step it back out, swings right side. Tolbert, three ball from the right wing, that's money. Talking his trash to Killeen Taylor there on the way back. Robinson quickly the other way, now moving right to left for Wabash Valley. Hands off to Henderson. Lucas Henderson calls for a screen from McGowan. Here he comes. Henderson around it to the left. Picked up his dribble, swings it to Killeen Taylor. Killeen Taylor crossing over, drives into the paint, spins just outside the restricted area, kicks it, top of the key. Daniel Robinson, three ball, money.
That's how you clap back. That's how you clap back right there.
44-40, four-point game. Kaskaskia with the ball. Tolbert will run the point up top. Henderson over him defensively. Tolbert drives towards the left wing. Now swings it. Robinson almost took that one away. Vassar drives in. Hop step goes up. Little floater outside the restricted line. And it falls. Vassar, talented scorer, 15 a game, scored there. Robinson quickly the other way. Swings it. Razor Moore. Now McGowan. Left wing. He'll cut in. Drives in the paint. Gather steps. Goes up. He got hacked. He'll go to the free throw line. Both teams playing some good offense here to start.
Yeah, it's very clean offense, this Warriors team. I thought they were going to play a little bit of iso ball, you know, just a tad bit. But, no, doing a really good job. Daniel Robinson finding his open spot, getting open, being able to make a big three after, you know, Tolbert with Taylor in his face is able to knock down a three. Tolbert.
He's down.
He's a good player.
McGowan missed his first free throw there. That's still 46-40. Second one's up. That one's nothing but net. 46-41, 18-23 left in this one here at the Spencer Sports Center. Kaskaskia with a five-point lead. And it's their ball. Tolbert will bring it up. Henderson will pick him up defensively. Tolbert drives to the left. Looking for a cutter. Now he'll swing over short corner. Jenkins lost the ball out of bounds. Kind of a bad pass there. Jenkins tried to corral it. He couldn't. And Wabash Valley creates a turnover.
I couldn't tell if maybe it may or may not have looked like Robinson with the shove, but, you know.
Referee was right there and did not call it. We'll take it. Robinson now running the point, swings over. Razor Moore over the logo for Wabash Valley. 20 on the shot clock. Moore around the screen from McGowan. He'll pull up just outside the elbow, and it's money. That is his bread and butter. Mid-range jump shots around the elbow area. He can rise above anybody and shoot it pure. 46-43. It's within 3 points for Wabash Valley. Kaskaskia. It's swung over. Vassar in the left corner. He'll swing. Jenkins up top. He'll take a three ball. Contested by McGowan. No good. Put back no good from Hodges. Robinson the rebound. Robinson the other way. And it's a free throw line. He'll pull up for two. That one short off the rim. Rebound knocked around. Jenkins has it. Outlet pass to Tolbert. Up to Vassar. He'll throw up the lob. And it's finished, slammed home by Lionel Hodges.
It's just a bad possession right there from the Warriors. Robinson just pulling up on transition. Got to slow it down.
Robinson will run the point once more here for Wabash Valley. He'll swing over. Taylor at Stopski. He drives into the rack at the right elbow or block area, and he's fouled. No shot up. Fouled on the floor. That one's going to be. And now another technical against Kaskaskia. We've seen that they like to talk their trash when they make it, and they don't like it when calls go against their way. So it looks like Hodges picked up a technical foul there.
I mean, yeah, the Warriors just got to cash in on the technical free throws. They haven't, and that's another thing that we probably should have talked about is the free throws today. The Warriors just haven't been able to knock them.
Oh, and by the way, Lionel Hodges just fouled out. And he started this game. I didn't really think about it. He just kind of has been picking them up along the way. And now Lionel Hodges, or one of their big men, is going to be on the bench, I believe. I believe he's got five fouls. Henderson at the free throw line for the technical free throw, and that one falls in. The first one. Now he'll have another here. 48-44, chance to make it within 3 points.
Talk about how big that is. You know, Hodges, the big guy for this Kaskaskia team. That makes this Kaskaskia team smaller. And now could help out to the Warriors' benefit.
Henderson missed the second free throw, so it's a four-point game. Wabash Valley with the ball, 48-44. Kaskaskia with the lead, 17:09 left in this one. Chicken in for Hodges there. It was Lath Hawksworth. He's 6'7", but he's skinnier. But he does have the height and the arms. Taylor on the trigger for Wabash Valley. Looking for help. He throws this one in. Razor Moore, left corner, three ball. No good. Rebounded Jenkins. Quick in transition. Kamari Slaughter around Robinson. Now driving to the rack. Throws up a shot. It's no good. Got his own rebound and dump off pass to Vassar, and he gets an easy layup at the right block. Robinson going quickly here the other way for Wabash Valley. Finds Razor Moore. He'll cut in. Now he'll kick it out. Taylor thought about the three. He drives into the lane. Hop steps. Goes up at the block, and he got it to go. Both teams going fast here now. Tolbert the other way. Finds Slaughter at the block area. He'll bounce it past to Jenkins. He loses the ball. Taylor takes it away. Up to Robinson. Two on one, and Robinson's fouled. Tolbert stopped an easy fast break basket there with the foul. If this were the NBA, I believe that would have been a transition take foul.
Yeah, so what I'm seeing is, you know, fast pace. I think the, you know, Kaskaskia was able to fasten up the pace right there, but the Warriors answered nicely. Taylor with a nice bucket should have been called an and one. Like we said, these refs are letting him play today.
Taylor inbounding from just to the right of his own bench. Sprinkles now up high left side. 25 on the shot clock. Back to Robinson up top. Around a screen from McGowan. Going to the right side. He'll cut in that short corner area. Kicks it to McGowan. Almost lost it. He's got it back. Drive to the paint. You're a step. Goes up with the left hand off the glass. No good. No. Then it falls. Thought that one was not going to fall in, but it did. Got the lucky bounce. It's a two-point gain. 50-48. Kaskaskia trying to protect the lead. They've got the ball. Tolbert will bring it up. Robinson guards him defensively. Tolbert towards the left side. We'll kick it to Vassar. Top of the key. Three ball. That one's well short just off the rim. But Slaughter right there for the offensive rebound and too easy of a putback. Four-point game now. Robinson the other way. Slows it down for the Warriors. Around a screen from McGowan. Kicks it. Brandon Razor Moore. Fake the three. Now kick it over to McGowan. Just inside the three-point line. crosses over into the paint area, bounce pass to Sprinkles. No, we called a, got called for a travel there.
Yeah, I think that's the right call there, you know, and that's what happens, you know, when everything's sped up. You make little mistakes like that, but the Warriors doing a really good job of just, they're getting good shots. I mean, Brandon Razor Moore's taking shots, and we didn't see a lot of that in the first half.
So we'll bring it up for Kaskaskia. They got a 4-point lead right now, trying to add to it. Slaughter up high, left side. He'll swing to Hawksworth on the left wing. Swings it up, back up top, top of the key. Jenkins got away with the travel. Swings over to Tolbert, left side. Tolbert jab steps, looking for help. Gets it to Slaughter. 10 on the shot clock. Slaughter drives in towards the paint. Pulls up at the free throw line. Jump shot too strong. No, it falls in. Hit the back iron, then the front iron, and then fell in. And now almost a turnover there. Taylor wasn't looking for the pass. He got it back. He'll swing it over to Robinson. He'll slow it down. Run the point. Robinson cuts in. Hop step. Goes up at the block. Off the glass and good. Robinson showing off the slashing ability there. Back within four. Kaskaskia the other way here. 54-50, 14-50 left in the first or this second half here. Tolbert way up high, directing traffic. 20 on the shot clock. Over the left wing, Tolbert still looking for help. Picks up his dribble. Robinson all there. Vassar now top of the key. Razor Moore picks his pocket. Breakaway to the rack. Razor Moore slams it home. It's a 2-point game. Brandon Razor Moore showing off the defense, leading to the flashy offense with the dunk. Now the crowd getting into it here at the Spencer Sports Center. Tolbert up top, Robinson over him. Tolbert around the screen, top of the key. McGowan picks him up now. Tolbert over the right wing. He thought about pulling up for three. Now finds Jenkins outside the block. Now Hawksworth spins, goes up with the left hook. Off the back iron and falls in. Both teams, offense, offense, offense. 56-52, 14 minutes left. Robinson left side. Calls out the play, goes around a screen from McGowan, finds him on the cut, he goes up, and he's fouled. Almost had an end one, couldn't quite finish it, but he got fouled hard. He'll go to the free throw line, a chance to get it back within three or two if he can make both. But first, before we get the free throws, we are going to have a timeout here. A good one still, and it's going to be a good one at the end. 56-52, Wabash Valley, though, on their way back. When we come back from the timeout, McGowan will be at the free throw line. 13:52 left in this one. We'll be back here in 1 minute.
New year, new style. Timberlake Furniture is kicking off the new year with the biggest sale to date. Whether it's a new mattress, cozy sofa, large dining set, or a statement piece that steals the show, Timberlake Furniture has it all. And with this sale's exclusive discounts, it's easier than ever to achieve your dream space. Make your house feel like home and stop by Timberlake Furniture to explore 5 acres of inspiration.
College doesn't have to start at an expensive school far away. You can save money and be close to home at Wabash Valley College. Many careers only require a 2-year degree or certificate. Or get your general education classes out of the way and transfer to a 4-year school. Wabash Valley College has programs in high-demand careers such as physical therapy assistant, advanced manufacturing, marketing, business management, nursing, and radio television. To find out more about Wabash Valley College, go to iecc.edu/WVC.
Zach Reynolds, Austin Harrelson back here with you on 89.1 The Bash and News Channel 15 YouTube, the Warrior Sports Network. It's a good Grack matchup here right now. 56-52, Kaskaskia with the lead, a 4-point lead, but Julian McGowan for the Warriors at the free throw line shooting two coming out of the timeout. That pick and roll has worked really good with him. He's so athletic. He gets that a good bounce pass and he can fly to the rim. Got fouled the last time, and that's why he's at the charity stripe. First free throw up. And it's money.
Kaskaskia not doing a very well job guarding the pick and roll either. They're not trying to switch, but whoever's guarding McGowan has to help off McGowan to, you know, gives a defender a chance to get back into place, and McGowan's just finding himself wide open.
I made both free throws there, and now it's a 2-point game. Now McGowan to the bench, and Diop checks back in for the first time in the second half. 2-point game, 56-54, 13:50 left in this one. Kaskaskia with that 2-point lead with the ball. Tolbert calling out the play. He'll dribble towards the left side. Finds Vassar, left corner, just inside the 3-point line. He'll take the 2-point jump shot. He made it, and he got fouled on the follow through. It's going to be look like either Diop or Sprinkles. Weird and one play there.
Yeah, no, and, you know, we've talked about how great this Warriors offense looks, but Kaskaskia's offense keeps matching what this Warriors offense is doing. The Warriors just need to get a stop. Just a couple stops, you know. The offense looks fine, and they're not even attacking. You know, Kaskaskia's not even really attacking the paint as much. They are dominating so far on the perimeter.
Vassar's free throws up. It's money. That completes the three-point play. It's now 59-54. The two-point lead balloons to five there. Robinson running the point around the screen from Reza Moore, and then Diop finds Diop on the cut to the basket, off the glass and good. Perfect pick and roll right there. Wabash Valley still good on offense. They need this stop. Slaughter over the left wing. Thought about pulling off the three. Diop picks his pocket. Going the other way. Two on two. Diop finds Sprinkles. He'll cut in. Floater just outside the restricted line. It falls. It's money. It's a one-point game. 59-58. 13 minutes left in this one. Got there at one stop there from the Diop steal. They need another one here that could take the lead. Tolbert, bounce pass. Jenkins at the right elbow. Spins around. Now he'll dribble. Hands off to Vassar. Lost it. Jenkins gets it back. Sprinkles knocks it out of bounds. Sprinkles playing tough defense.
Yeah,
stays with Kaskaskia. There's only 12 on the shot clock, though.
Kaskaskia trying to run some form of, you know, half-court offense. This is not working. This Warriors team's able to switch on screens. That's what this Kaskaskia offense is off-ball screens. And this Warriors team switching everything.
Vassar will inbound it, finds Tolbert at the top of the key. Around a screen, thought about pulling up. Razor Moore's in his face. He drives to the rack, spins at the right, at the left block, and he calls the tie-up. Razor Moore and Robinson got their hands in on it. Possession arrow stays with Kaskaskia. Only 5 seconds on the shot clock. Underneath their own basket, just to the left of it. Tolbert on the trigger. Looking for help. He'll find Jenkins. He almost lost it. He did lose it. Diop gets another steal, but then he traveled with it. He picked the ball up and then got going, but didn't dribble. He traveled and gave it right back to Kaskaskia. And they get a fresh 20 or 30 on the shot clock.
Man, this defense from Sprinkles and Diop really have, you know, come off the bench into the second half, and they're showing some great signs defensively.
Vassar finds Tolbert, left corner, two ball, foot on the line, he made it. Just two, makes it 61-58, three-point game. Quickly, Sprinkles the other way, right wing. Hawksworth in his face. Sprinkles drives to the rack. He's fouled on the drive. We'll have to inbound it. That's going to be on Leith Hawksworth, the 6'7" freshman local kid from Johnston City. Not too far.
Yeah, back in my heyday, you know, I had to play him in the Goreville tournament. Very good player.
He's a bit taller than you are.
Yeah, just a little bit.
Taylor on the trigger for Wabash Valley. Throws it up. Robinson at alone at the top of the key. Slaughter closed out. Robinson drives in, kicks. Taylor right corner. Three ball. Too strong. Hawksworth the rebound. Up to Slaughter in transition, and Taylor fouled him, trying to knock that away.
That's a tough play there. I think that's a good play. You know, a good foul there from Taylor.
Gives the defense a chance to set up now instead of having to chase in transition.
Well, I mean, this Kaskaskia team, you know, their transition offense is very, very well, and that's why they're ahead in this game. And so this Warriors team just has to do a better job of, as soon as that shot, and it's so hard being on the court, but as soon as that shot goes up, you've got to get back.
Running the point now is Slaughter. He'll get it to the right elbow. That's Jenkins with it. Looking for a cutter, and he'll hand off. Slaughter at the left elbow. They'll take a jump shot. It's too strong. Henderson the rebound. Wabash Valley the other way. Henderson to Sprinkles. One power dribble, and he's fouled, trying to go up. I don't know if they're going to give him the shot attempt there. One referee says that he was going up. At the very least, it would be bonus. So it looks like they'll make the sign. It's a 1-1. So Sprinkles at the line for the bonus. Got to make the first to earn the second.
Like you said, it's going to be a close ball game. And, you know, I think the Warriors have really, they've looked increasingly better on defense. Sometimes they just aren't switching, you know, and we've seen it a couple times. When Diop comes in, you know, it's a little bit slower, you know, switching, but.
Sprinkles made the first free throw, so he earns the second, a chance to make it a one-point game if he makes this second one. Sprinkles up with free throw. It's good. 61-60. 12:05 left in this one. Kaskaskia with the ball. Wabash Valley right on their heels, though. Sprinkles will pick up Tolbert in the half court. Tolbert letting things develop. 20 on the shot clock. Right side, Vassar with it. Right wing, Henderson on him. He'll drive towards the corner, trying to back down Henderson. He's at the right block. Spins. Picked up his dribble. Kicked it out to Hawksworth. Now it's out of the key. Tolbert with it. He'll pull up for three from the top. That one's off to the left line. In for the rebound. Slaughter put back. No good. Follow off to the left side of the rim. Slaughter gets his own rebound again. Throws it up to Vassar. Vassar hits in. Slaughter in the corner. He'll drive to the paint. South of the key. Jenkins wide open. Three ball. That one is no good. Rebound this time to Taylor. They finally get one. Wabash Valley a chance to take the lead. Taylor the other way. He'll run the point. Lost the dribble, ends up in the hands of Vassar. He turned it over. Vassar the other way. Finds Slaughter. Back in to Jenkins at the block, and he's fouled by Taylor. Jenkins with 14 points would go to the free throw line.
You know, this Warriors team had a great opportunity there. Taylor just not able to keep it corralled. Tough break there for the Warriors.
Absolutely. And then on the defensive end, you can't get the rebound. They're giving too many second chance opportunities. Jenkins makes his first free throw there. Makes it 62-60. McGowan and Robinson check in for Wabash Valley. Diop and Taylor to the bench. 62-60 to the score. 11:13 left in this one here at the Spencer Sports Center. Jenkins' second free throw is good as well. That makes it 63-60. Three-pointer could tie it here. Two-pointer will get them within one. Robinson brings it up the court for the Warriors. Around the screen from McGowan, driving to the right. Finds McGowan, driving to the basket. Off the glass, no good. It was too strong. He's fouled on the rebound, and they don't call it. McGowan's got to get back up. Vassar the other way. Cuts in. Picked it up, stopped at the elbow. Hands off. Slaughter drives into the rack. Off the glass, no good. Gets bailed out by a foul call. I just do not know how they said that McGowan didn't get fouled on that rebound. He got shoved to the ground by Will Vassar, and they just didn't call it. And Coach Terrence McGee beside himself.
Yeah, no, I mean, I think it's a blatant foul there, but then, you know, in my opinion, they call a weak foul down here on the other end.
Well, Slaughter at the free throw line made the first one, and now it's all of a sudden a four-point game. If he makes his next one, it'll be a five-point game, all on free throws. Kamari Slaughter at the free throw line. Shot up. It's too strong. Rebound on the floor, and Jenkins comes away with it. McGowan had his hands on it. Couldn't squeeze it. Another possession.
Tough break for the Warriors right there.
Tolbert over the logo. 10 on the shot clock. Swings it. Left side, Vassar. He's got an opening to the rack off the glass, and it rolls in. A six-point swing there. Wabash Valley needs a timeout. They're still within six, but momentum going Kaskaskia's way right now. Plenty of time left. It's 66-60 Kaskaskia with the lead. 10:33 left in this one. Don't go anywhere. We will be back in 1 minute.
Before coming to Senior Enrichment Center, I was so depressed that I couldn't get out of bed. That all changed once I started seeing Danielle, the social worker, and Melanie, the nurse. They have been so kind, and they truly care about my health. They have helped me to be able to go out and have shown me the importance of how to deal with my problems in a more constructive way. I think anyone who is experiencing grief, depression, anxiety, or isolation can benefit from this program. The Senior Enrichment Center has changed my life.
Back here at the Spencer Sports Center, six-point game. The Kaskaskia Blue Devils with a 66-60 lead over the home Wabash Valley Warriors. A big swing there, mostly all on free throws, but also a big part of it, too many offensive rebounds for Kaskaskia.
Yeah, and you know, we talked about this before the game, how the Blue Devils can come out quickly and, you know, create a lead. And, you know, that was one thing, second chance points. You know, you let the bigger team, you know that the team is bigger and they're good at rebounding. It's not even that they're that much bigger, it's that this team is so good at rebounding. You just got to quit that.
Robinson running the point for Wabash Valley after the timeout. Still a lot of time, 10:25 left, only a six-point game. Robinson at the elbow, kicks it out to McGowan. 15 on the shot clock. McGowan thought about pulling up. Now he'll find Henderson in the left corner. Directing traffic. Henderson will drive to the baseline now. Got open. Blew by his man and finished at the rack. 66-62. Cash Henderson there. Tolbert quickly the other way. Swings over to Slaughter. He'll get it right back to Tolbert. They'll run a play. Tolbert around the screen from Hawksworth. Tried to find him on the cut. He did. He's in at the block. Throws it up with the left hand. It's off the glass. No good. Rebound off the hands of Hawksworth. Wabash Valley ball. Ended up out of bounds. Almost got another rebound there. One on two, but he knocked it out of bounds. Wabash Valley caught the break. They'll go the other way here. 4-point game. Chance to get within a couple. Robinson around the screen from McGowan. At the right elbow. Now the right block. Kicks it right corner. Sprinkles. Three ball. Too short. Hit the front of the rim there. Rebound the other way with Kaskaskia. Tolbert quickly gather steps. Throws up a shot. No good off the back iron. Tip back. No good. Rebound. Knocked out of bounds. Off the hand of Brandon Razor Moore. Stays with Kaskaskia.
Yes, still this Kaskaskia team fighting for each and every single rebound. Just a missed opportunity from Sprinkles.
Tolbert inbounds it to Slaughter up top. He'll slow it down. Run a play. 15 on the shot clock. Slaughter directs traffic. Dribble handoff to Vassar. He'll hand off to Tolbert over the left wing. Sprinkles on him. Tolbert drives in. Goes up at the block. He's fouled by Sprinkles. Sprinkles didn't like the call. Tolbert went flying to the deck. Now he'll go to the charity stripe.
It's just fouls. You know, the free throws are going to be, you know, potentially what decides this ball game. You know, Kaskaskia is going to the line. They're attacking. They're, you know, finding contact. Now, some of the foul calls have been a little bit questionable.
It's worth mentioning now with Warriors with 5 team fouls, Blue Devils with 7. From here on out, it'll be the bonus for any foul. That's going to be a big part. And a big part there for Wabash Valley is Tolbert missed the free throw. It's well short off the front of the rim. Taylor and Burton check in for Wabash Valley. Henderson and Sprinkles to the bench. 5 on the floor is Robinson, Taylor, McGowan, Razor Moore, and Burton. Tolbert, second free throw up. He missed them both. Rebound, Brandon Razor Moore. Big time opportunity there. Quickly up to Burton, right wing. Showing off the dribble moves. He'll get it back to Taylor. Top of the key. Working against Hawksworth. Drives to the rack. Kicks it left corner. Robinson, three ball. In and out. Razor Moore flies in for the rebound. Put back and one. Brandon Razor Moore with the and one put back. And just like that, Wabash Valley within two. A chance to be within one if he makes this free throw.
See, the Warriors figuring out, you know, what happens when you go for rebounds? What happens when you go for second chance opportunities like Kaskaskia? Brandon Razor Moore coming in and doing just that.
Free throws up. It's good. It's a 1-point game. Brandon Razor Moore with a 3-point swing there. 66-65. Kaskaskia with that 1-point lead and even 9 minutes left in this one. Checking in for Kaskaskia is going to be Anthony Sanford. It's his first action today. Freshman from St. Louis, Missouri, 6'4". He'll check in. 1-point game, 9 minutes left. Tolbert will bring it up the floor. Burton will pick him up. Tolbert looks to his bench for the play. Now he'll call it out. Dribbles towards the right side, hands off to Vassar. Vassar over the right wing, swings over to the left wing. Slaughter with it. Tolbert now right wing, looking inside. Bounce pass into Jenkins at the block. He'll back down, spins, goes up. No good, no foul call. Rebound to Kaleem Taylor. McGowan with good straight-up defense. Wabash Valley a chance to take the lead. Taylor driving in at the free throw line. Now he'll cut in at the block, spins. Kicks to Moore outside at the right wing. He'll pull up, three ball. In and out. Oh, it spun around. Rebound to Kaskaskia the other way. Slaughter with it. Still a 1-point game. Slaughter driving on McGowan. Now he'll step it back. McGowan rejects the shot. Slaughter gets his rebound back. 15 on the shot clock. Left side. Tolbert with it. He'll drive towards the baseline. Kicks it out to Sanford. Now it's out the key. Vassar, Robinson in his face. 8 on the shot clock. Vassar driving. He's fouled. Pump fake got Robinson in the air. Good move there by Vassar to earn the foul. He'll go to the free throw line. Vassar with 16 points for Kaskaskia. Jenkins also has 16 for him. He had 14 in the first half. He's been pretty quiet in the second half so far.
I was just about to point that
out. But he's still rebounding a ton for him.
And, you know, that's what you're going to get with Jenkins, though. Jenkins is, you know, one of the better players on this Kaskaskia team.
They've got 4 guys in double figures, which is pretty much what their average is anyway. They're a true team. They do the same thing most every night. Vassar, first free throw was good. Second is as well. 3-point game, 68-65. Robinson brings it up for the Warriors. Up high over the right side, he'll go around a screen from McGowan. Bounce pass to McGowan, drives towards the rack, double team comes, he steps it back out, kicks it. Brendan Rizmore wide open, top of the key, three ball, too strong. Jenkins with the rebound. But he throws it away, Robinson takes it, spins, goes up with the block, he got it. It's a 1-point game again. Robinson's got to get back on defense. Tolbert with the floater. Off the back iron, no good. Rebound, Colleen Taylor. Wabash Valley, a chance to take the lead. Taylor gets past Sanford. And at the block, he goes up. And he got it to go. Wabash Valley takes the lead. Should have been an and one. Doesn't matter. They got the lead. 1 point, 69-68. 7:15 left. Kaskaskia now are trying to slow it down. Crowd here at the Spencer Sports Center getting into it. Vassar, left wing, jabs. He lost the ball out of bounds. That stays with Kaskaskia. Robinson knocked it out. Vassar will inbound it from in front of his own bench. 15 on the shot clock. Now they'll switch to Sanford on the inbound. Slaughter up top. Into the right elbow. Vassar hands off to Slaughter. He cuts in and one for Kamari Slaughter. Went up at the right block. Got slapped a bit on the shoulder, was able to finish. Blue Devils take a 1-point lead back. A free throw here would make it a 2-point lead.
It feels like, you know, any time this Warriors team catches some form of momentum, Kaskaskia just keeps fighting.
Slaughter, free throw up, that's good. It's 71-69, 6 minutes, 58 seconds left. A 2 to tie, a 3 to take the lead back for Wabash Valley. Robinson calls out for a screen, goes around it on the right side. Drives to the baseline. He got fouled by Jenkins. Breached in on him. Not sure why Jenkins is complaining about that foul call. It's pretty obvious. And it'll be bonus, so Daniel Robinson going to the free throw line.
That's what's huge now. You know, regardless, you know, attack the paint. You're in the bonus. And this team's doing a really good job of finishing through contact.
9 team fouls for the Blue Devils. One more and Wabash Valley would be in the double bonus, which would mean 2 free throws no matter what. Right now, Robinson still needs to hit the first to earn the second. Clutch free throws here. Robinson's first one is up. It's money. 1-point game. A chance to tie it here. Robinson's free throws up. It's no good. Fell off the right side. It's still a 1-point lead for Kaskaskia. He'll come the other way. Tolbert to run the point. Now he'll throw it up to Slaughter. Vassar left side. Looking for help. Now Jenkins at the top of the key. Right side handoff. Slaughter with it. 15 on the shot clock. Left side Tolbert. Finds Jenkins on the cut. He wasn't ready for the pass. He got it back. Kicks to Slaughter up top. 9 on the shot clock. Slaughter kicks it. Vassar left wing. 3 ball. Money. Boy. What a shot there from Vassar. 74-70. McGowan, right wing. On the dribble, hands off to Brandon Razor Moore. Moore around the screen, now he'll dribble it back out. Now around the screen to the right. Swings all the way across. Taylor, left corner, 3 ball. In and out, just unlucky bounces for Wabash Valley. Tolbert the other way, almost lost his dribble, otherwise he would have had a fast break bucket. McGowan, chased down, block. Taylor the other way. To the corner, Robinson, left corner, 3 ball. Money! 1-point game. McGowan, the chase down block, the 3 ball on the other end. Quickly, Slaughter into the paint. A blocking foul, Slaughter to the free throw line. McGowan couldn't get his feet set. Almost had a charge, he couldn't get the feet quite set. Now, Slaughter did blow the layup, so it's not an and one. That's going to be 4 fouls, though, on Julian McGowan. One more and he's done.
Yeah, we talked about earlier in this game how important his defensive versatility is and how he's able to recover. He can guard 1 through 5. He has shown, you know, he's got 9 points, but the most important aspect of his game is how great he is defensively. And we keep seeing it time and time again.
Slaughter makes the free throw there, makes it a 2-point game. Sprinkles is going to check in. McGowan's got to go to the bench with 4 fouls. Slaughter back to the free throw line. Second free throw's up. He missed it. Rebound with Wabash Valley. Burton able to save it. 4-1 out of bounds. 2-point game. 75-73. 5:30 left. Burton drives. Kicks to Sprinkles in the left corner. He jab steps right, now drives to the baseline. Spins in at the block, goes up, and one! Sprinkles! The hoop in the arm, it's a tie game. A chance to take the lead if he hits the free throw.
Ooh, that's a big bucket there for the Warriors.
That's grown man basketball right there.
That was just, you know, who wants it more? That was Adrian Sprinkles just doing his thing.
Tied up at 75 apiece. Sprinkles at the free throw line. Free throw up, too strong. Rebound to Jenkins. Tie game, 75-75. 5:20 left in this one. Tolbert brings it up to court for Kaskaskia. The Warriors need a stop. Tolbert on the left side around a screen. Now he'll dribble back towards the left. Top the key around another screen. Tolbert kicks it to Vassar just outside the left elbow. He'll step back, hand off to Jenkins. Pass knocked out of bounds by Burton. Tried to find the cutter. Vassar, good deed by Burton, and knock it out of bounds. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Got to hold strong here. No fouls. No easy baskets. Force a tough shot at the end of the shot clock. Slaughter on the trigger for Kaskaskia. Taylor guards him face up. Looking for help. Jenkins bounce passer. Make that Sanford. He lost the ball out of bounds. It was wide open. Wide open underneath the basket. Everything went wrong there for Wabash Valley, and then Sanford just fumbled the ball out.
You know, there's catching a break, and then there's what just happened right there.
Huge. Have to take advantage. Tie game. Wabash Valley a chance to take the lead. Under 5 minutes now. 4 minutes, 55 seconds to be exact. Robinson up top on the right side. Around a screen from Brandon Razor Moore. Over the top, guarded by Slaughter. Left side, Sprinkles. He'll drive into the free throw line. Behind the back, down to the block. Spins, lost his dribble. Taken away by Kaskaskia. Slaughter tried to bounce past it to the cutting Tolbert. It got kicked out of bounds. It'll stay with Kaskaskia, but Wabash Valley can set up the defense.
Tough break right there. Wabash, you know, getting a stop, getting a break, and just not being able to cash in.
Coach McGee going to take a timeout here. What did we tell you in the open? This one's going to be great all the way to the end. We're tied up 75 apiece with 4 minutes, 39 seconds left. Don't go anywhere. Be back in 1 minute for this exciting finish of Grack basketball.
New year, new style. Timberlake Furniture is kicking off the new year with the biggest sale to date. Whether it's a new mattress, cozy sofa, large dining set, or a statement piece that steals the show, Timberlake Furniture has it all. And with this sale's exclusive discounts, it's easier than ever to achieve your dream space. Make your house feel like home and stop by Timberlake Furniture to explore 5 acres of inspiration. You already know that the First National Bank is your real community bank, but have you met our people? It's the people inside that make us a community bank. We live here. We work here. We're your neighbors and your friends. When you bank with us, your money is reinvested in your community. At the First National Bank, our customers are more than an account number. People are the reason for this community. We're your hometown bank, serving the area since 1906. We are the First National Bank, where our people make the difference. Come see us today. Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Back here at the Spencer Sports Center. All tied up at 75 apiece. The Kaskaskia Blue Devils in Wabash Valley Warriors House. The Spencer Sports Center. Zach Reynolds, Austin Harrelson here with you, bringing you the action. Talked about earlier on, Daniel Robinson putting together a really good stretch of games. Well, add another one to the list. He's got 17 points right now. We'll see what he can do to try to get Wabash Valley this win. Kaskaskia's ball underneath their own basket. On the trigger, it was Tolbert. He inbounds to Slaughter. He'll slow it down. He'll dribble out to the logo. Now around the screen. He'll fly to the rack. At the right block, he blew the layup. Rebound tapped around. Tolbert's got it. Tolbert flying to the rack. Lost the dribble. Burton pickpocketed. Up to Razor Moore. Ahead of the pack. He lost it out of bounds. Got to get back on defense now. Brandon Razor Moore ahead of the pack. This slipped out of his hands. Out of bounds is the best way I can describe it. 4 minutes, 20 seconds left. Still tied up at 75 apiece. Both teams catching breaks. Tolbert directing traffic. He'll dribble towards the right. Burton guarding him. Right wing now up top. Slaughter, top of the key. He'll cut in. Now over towards the corner, inside the three-point arc. He'll kick it back out. Tolbert up top on the right side. Now he'll dribble. Cuts in. Goes up at the block and one. Isaiah Tolbert. Tolbert, one of their best players, showed it off right there.
I mean, he has shown the ability all day to space out the floor, shoot from deep, and just incredible finishing. And then going back to the Brandon Razor Moore play, I mean, it's just tough. You know, we just saw the same thing for Kaskaskia. And so, you know, you just got a five-second memory. That's what they always say.
McGowan checks back in. He'll have to be careful on defense. He's got four fouls. They don't call the lane violation. But the Blue Devils, Tolbert made the free throw, so they have a three-point lead. Probably could have got another one. There was a lane violation there. Didn't get called. Going to have a timeout here, but we're not going to take a break. We're going to keep it right here because this is some big moments. Kaskaskia with a three-point lead, 78-75. 3 minutes, 56 seconds left. This has been some chaotic stuff here in the last couple of minutes with teams having wide open dunk opportunities and not ball going out of bounds. Some and ones on each side. It's been pretty chaotic. It's been really fun. What does Wabash Valley need to do, Austin, here to complete this comeback, really, if that is what it is?
So, Zach, what have they done a really good job of offensively in the second half is attacking the paint. They've been able to finish through contact, and it's just got to be at the right time. You know, I feel like, you know, after they get one of those big buckets, they try to go back there, you know, back down the court, and they just try to go for the same thing. It's not... This team is very good in a half-court setting. This, you know, the transition offense is for Kaskaskia. This Warriors team isn't that great on transition offense. They've had their, you know, they've shown that they could score on transition, but this is a half-court team. Just run through your offense. It's a three-point game. You don't need anything crazy, but defensively, you have to protect the paint. You have to protect the paint because we're seeing
too many
and ones and too many open opportunities. And, you know, luckily, all those opportunities haven't cashed in, but this Kaskaskia team is attacking the paint, you know. And so this Warriors team just needs to sharpen up on defense and run through the offense. Find open buckets because guess what? You're getting them if you run through this offense.
Robinson will bring it up to court, and he'll try to do just that for Wabash Valley. Calls for a screen from McGowan. He'll go on it to the right, towards the right corner. Now he'll take it back towards the left, cuts into the paint area, goes up at the free throw line, and it falls in. Should have been an and one. Didn't get the call. All sorts of contact. He made that jump shot anyway. It's a one-point game. Kaskaskia the other way, left to right. Tolbert, their point guard with it. Had the and one moments ago. He'll get it to Jenkins, make that Sanford. Now Jenkins on the right side at the block and missed it. Slaughter missed it. Sanford got the rebound back, put backs up, and one. McGowan is straight up. He is straight up, and they call a foul, and now McGowan is fouled out. That is terrible.
Stay tough.
He's straight up. He cannot do anything else.
That's a tough break right there, you know, and plus losing McGowan, that's tough. We've seen how important McGowan is, you know.
I'm complaining about the officials here because that was a bad call, but at the same time, Wabash Valley cannot allow that first look that they got lucky that
absolutely
missed.
Absolutely not.
And they can't allow the offensive rebound.
That's what we're just talking about, is that this team is allowing way too many open opportunities just right under the basket.
Three-point game now. Chance to make it 4 with Sanford at the free throw line. Shot up. That's good. An ugly jump shot, but it went in. That's all that matters. 81-77 now. Wabash Valley trying to build momentum back up. 3 minutes, 15 seconds left. Clock's not running. It is now. 3 minutes, 15 seconds. A foul there. They don't call it. Tolbert takes it away. He steps out of bounds. How is that not a foul, Austin?
I mean, it's so ticky-tacky, especially here in the second half. I feel like the first half, it was, you know, look, this has got to be blatant for it to be called. And now in the second half, it's ticky-tacky. But both teams fouling a lot.
Both teams in the double bonus now. Taylor on the inbound. Finds Lucas Henderson over the logo. 20 on the shot clock. Henderson picks up his dribble. Finds Sprinkles left side. Left wing. Sprinkles on the dribble. Kicks it. Brandon Razor-Moore. Right wing. Three ball. No good. Rebound to Tolbert. Tolbert slows it down. He'll bring it up to court. Clock on Kaskaskia's side now. It's under 3 minutes. Tolbert finds Sanford. The cut into Vassar. Lost his dribble. Nobody's going for the ball on the floor. Vassar gets it back. Can kill some more clock. Left side, Vassarweather. He thought about the three. Now he'll hand off. Slaughter on the dribble. Short corner. Sanford with it. Trying to back down Sprinkles. Throws up a heave. No good. That's a foul. They didn't call it. Wabash Valley gets the rebound anyway. Henderson behind the back dribble. Cuts into the paint. Goes up at the right block. And the finish with the finger roll. 2-point game. They need another stop.
Huge bucket there for the Warriors. You just got to get a stop. On ball pressure.
Slaughter over the logo. He'll hand off to Tolbert. They'll kill some clock here. Under 20 on the shot clock. Henderson guarding Tolbert. Slaughter right side. Taylor over him. Offensive fouls not being called down in the paint. Now they're going to call a foul on Robinson. He just, oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. I don't know how that you call that on Robinson and not on Jenkins.
Yeah, no. I mean, if you're going to call that on Robinson, then you got to go ahead and start making those calls towards Jenkins.
And Daniel Robinson also just fouled out. Two very weak foul calls have fouled out two very key members of this Wabash Valley team here in the last couple of minutes. So now Diop will check in, a little bit more size for Wabash Valley. I mean, Robinson's trying to guard a much bigger guy down in the paint, and I'm trying to paint the picture for you here. Jenkins is doing an illegal move where he's like, he's using his right arm and
he's hooking.
That's an offensive foul.
He's hooking.
Robinson trying to combat that gets called for a foul away from the ball. That's just bad. It's just bad. Jenkins at the free throw line. It's up and it's good. He makes it a 3-point game, 82-79. Under 2 minutes. It's a minute 59 left now. Wabash Valley playing two different teams right now.
Yeah. I couldn't agree more. But this Warriors team has to clutch up. You know, Daniel Robinson would have had the ball in his hands if he's still in, but...
Jenkins made both the free throws there, and now Kaskaskia is going to take a timeout. Sorry to cut you off.
No, you're good. Hey, you're good.
83-79 is the score. 1 minute, 59 seconds. We're going to keep it right here. there's a tough. I know that I got to be a little bit more partial here. I'm getting a little too hot-headed, I know. But Wabash Valley, with 2 minutes left, you can score a lot of points in 2 minutes in basketball. It's not over. But they've got a hill to climb right now. They've got the ball on offense. Coach McGee going to talk things over and try to run, get some plays going here.
So, you know, my thing was, you know, run the offense, see that you can get open looks, because they have been able to. But you're at a point in the game where you need a huge bucket. Who is the – honestly, if Daniel Robinson does not foul out of this game, the ball is in his hands. You keep the ball in his hands. But I think at this point in the game, you have – what's been successful is maybe not the pull-up threes, you know, off-dribble threes from Brandon Razor Moore. But what is he so good at? He's good around the mid-range area. Let him do his thing. He's a great finisher as well, very underrated finisher. Let Brandon Razor Moore – the ball is going to be in his hands.
I agree. His leaping ability helps him out so much as a jump shooter, because it's almost impossible to block his jump shot because he just rises.
Because he rises up above him.
He just jumps so high, even on the jump shot, especially from that elbow. From the elbow areas, he is just money. I'd like to see him get the ball as well. You can't force it, though.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I'm cutting you off too, man. That's my bad. Another thing is this pick and roll. If you have scored so many points off the pick and roll today, maybe some, you know, missed opportunities as well, but just, you know, you got off-ball movement has to be prevalent. It just has to be everywhere.
Under 2 minutes now. Kaleem Taylor will run the point. Around a screen from Brandon Razor-Moore all the way to the right wing. Taylor looking for help, trying to find a cutter. Now he'll cut into the rack. Reverse layup, no good. Diop put a rebound. He's blocked on the putback by Tolbert. It ends up out of bounds, stays with Wabash Valley. Tolbert runs the point guard for him, but he's 6'1", and he's got long arms. Blocked a much taller 6'6", Diop. Taylor on the trigger, 19 on the shot clock. Taylor needs help. Wabash Valley a little slow trying to run this play. Throw it up and get it into Diop just in time. Ball knocked out of bounds. Tolbert again. left inbound from in front of their own bench now. 17 on the shot clock.
I think it was a little bit of confusion there. No one was really moving.
Taylor on the trigger again here. Throws it up to Diop. He'll hand off to Brandon Razor-Moore. Slaughter guarding him. 13 on the shot clock. Razor-Moore around the screen. Almost lost his dribble. Henderson, top of the key. He got fouled. They didn't call it. Step back. Free ball. Cash money. They call him cash for a reason. It's a one-point game.
That's the big-time bucket that this team needed. Now they got to get a stop on defense.
Henderson now to guard Sober. Over the logo. Minute 15 left. One-point game. Jenkins has it. Just outside the right elbow. Throws the ball away. Taylor takes it away. Doesn't have numbers. Needs help. He's getting fouled, and they're not calling it. Taken away again. Slaughter into Tolbert. Right corner. Two-point shot. It's good. Three-point lead now for the Blue Devils. And they just keep getting every break from these officials. This is absurd. We're under a minute. Once again, want to keep it right here. 57.1 seconds left, a three-point game. A three ball could tie it for Wabash Valley, who will have the ball coming out of the timeout. I mean, let's not take away from that three ball from Lucas Henderson, the step back.
Shoo.
After he got fouled, they didn't call it. He stepped back, three ball. They call him, he likes to go by Cash Anderson, Lucas Henderson. And well, he's earned that nickname, the way he can shoot it.
Especially at a big point in the game like that. Like, it's a little bit different not doing it, you know, with 5 minutes left in the first half. You know, that's crunch time points, you know. And I think that this tough break right here for the Warriors, but it's still a one-possession game. I don't necessarily think that you don't have to go for the three here. You just have to get a open bucket. You have to get the smart bucket here. Don't force anything because... You know, you don't need a three. If it's wide open, of course. But, you know, just need clean basketball. Just a clean offensive possession here by the Warriors, and we'll see what happens.
Kaskaskia showed full court pressure. Now they'll back off. Taylor brings the ball up the court. Under a minute. Three-point game, 85-82. Taylor over the right side. Finds Henderson at the top. Fouled again. They don't call it. Extra pass. Kaleem Taylor, right wing, three ball. No good. Brandon Razor-Moore gets the rebound. And he almost fell out of bounds, had to throw it in, and Kaskaskia took it away. Vassar the other way. He'll dribble it out. Smart play by Vassar. Trying to kill the clock, and Razor-Moore has to foul Slaughter. Free throws could be a dagger here. Slaughter going to the line. Really smart there by Vassar. He had a fast break opportunity. Would have been in traffic. He just dribbled it out, killed that clock. Very heads-up play by Will Vassar.
For the Warriors, you at least have to go for a steal there. You know, there's still a shot clock.
Free throw good there by Slaughter. Makes it a four-point game. It's two possessions now. 32.3 seconds on the clock. Vassar listed as just a freshman, but he doesn't play like it. He's got 21 points for him. He can shoot it, he can drive, he can do it all. Slaughter, though, also having a great game. He's got 16. Missed that free throw. Four-point game. Got to go quick. Taylor, the rebound going the other way. 86-82. Taylor drives to the rack. Goes up and one. Khalid Taylor over the bigger Sanford. Sanford 6'4", 212. Khalid Taylor, he doesn't care. Goes up strong, got fouled, the hoop and the harm. Needs to hit this free throw to make it a one-point game.
We've seen Taylor do this the entire game. Drive in, and like we said, attack that paint and one big-time shot from Taylor.
24.2 seconds on the clock. Taylor, a good free throw shooter, over 70% on the year. Made it. One-point game, 86-85. Coach McGee takes a timeout to talk it over about how they're going to play defensively here. Once again, going to keep it right here.
Might as well not even call for a break.
One-point game. Kaleem Taylor showing off the slashing ability. He's been doing it all day, and no bigger spot than right there. He's got 12 points. We keep saying it. We've said this all game long. Wabash Valley's had, they scored 85 points. The offense is good. They've got to come away with a stop on defense.
Yeah, and, you know, you can do a couple things here. I don't think you necessarily have to foul right away as the ball is inbounded. You have to go for a steal here. Go for a steal. It's double bonus regardless. So go for the steal. If it gets called, you're in the same spot. You know, you just don't want too much time taken off the clock. But there's 24 seconds left. That is a lot of time.
A lot of time. And you know what? The big deal about that being an N1 and him hitting the free throw to complete the three-point play, it's 3 points. That makes it a one-point game. So if you foul, even if they hit both free throws,
it's still a one-possession game.
It's a one-possession game. So I agree, though. You go for the steal on the inbound, they catch it. Don't let too much time go off.
Yeah. Foul them.
But you can absolutely get a steal with full-court pressure. That'd be ideal. If not, foul them. And then
you just can't, even if you know, if they, which I don't see Kaskaskia trying to score here, but
shot clock is off.
Yeah, no, I mean, this is a spot where I think you just go for the steal, and if, you know, it gets called, but you go for the steal. We've seen how physical this game has been called today, and so if you're the Warriors, you just got to play physical defense. You've got, honestly, I would full court pressure.
And they are here.
Full court pressure. If something gets caught, you know, like I said, they also have an 8 second before they get past half court as well.
Sanford on the trigger, inbounds it in the corner. Tolbert up to Jenkins. They got to foul him. Now up to Vassar. Need to foul. They're still just trapping. Now they will foul. Henderson picks that one up. It felt like a lot of time. It's 15.6 seconds still left here. And now Tolbert to the free throw line. Trying to make both to make it a three-point game.
See, what just happened is fine, okay? You tried the full court pressure. They were able to beat it very easily. And you know Kaskaskia is not going to try and score.
They could have if they wanted to. They don't want to. And he missed the first free throw short off the front of the rim. So now, even if he makes this one, it'd only be a two-point game. With 15 seconds left, you could hold for the last shot.
Heck, the way I've seen Kaleem Taylor drive today, you've got to get the ball in his hands at this point.
Tolbert's free throws up. It's too strong, no good. Razor-Moore, Sprinkles gets the rebound. Razor-Moore was fouled. They didn't call it. 10 on the clock. Taylor the other way. One-point game. Timeout, Terrence McGee. 8.2 seconds left.
They could have been sent to the line very easily right there.
Oh, my God. I mean,
they should
once again, Brandon Razor-Moore going off that rebound. It gets mugged. No call. Didn't. Sprinkles, though. Went up and took that out of the sky anyway. And now this is it. This is it, folks. 8.2 seconds on the clock. A one-point game. 86-85. Kaskaskia with the lead. Wabash Valley with the ball. At this point, it's one shot. You win it or you lose it.
I think what has worked so well for the Warriors today, drive, drive, drive. They have been finishing through contact. You get that ball in Kaleem Taylor's hands. Or you can do a lot of things here. You can get it into Brandon Razor-Moore's hands. You know, call an ISO. Get something going. This inbounds play has to be well orchestrated as well.
It does. All right.
This team has a lot of opportunities here. 8 seconds, that's plenty of time to get a good shot.
And now they're going to double up on the timeout. So Coach McGee took one. Now as soon as it ends, the coach for Kaskaskia is going to take one. We get 2 minutes to talk this thing out.
So Burton coming in. You know, obviously at this
another
point,
shooting option.
You get shooting options. Burton has also shown he in this game he has the ability to make shots from deep, and so get some slack, get shooters, slashers, which is basically what this entire team is as it is.
Drive and kick,
and that's what this team is so good at. But do not force, like, it's 8 seconds, okay. I'm kind of torn between who gets the ball in this spot, you know, because we've seen the
traffic
ability.
Open. Yeah. Try not to force it. That, you know, that's the tough thing. Try not to force it to one guy. Try to run a play where potentially multiple people could get open.
And see, this is where this is really important. If Kaskaskia keeps running the same defense, the man-to-man, no switches, this could be huge. Mm-hmm. If you curl You curl a screen good enough, you can be wide open. It just depends on, you know, if I'm Kaskaskia right now, I am switching literally everything.
Henderson on the trigger. Sprinkles, Taylor. Burton, Razor Moore, Henderson. On the court. This is it. 1 point game. Henderson, my zone bench, inbound to Razor Moore. Now five. Razor Moore driving to the 3-point line. Hands off to Taylor. And they're going to call an offensive foul. It's a dribble handoff. And they call a moving screen on Razor Moore. It's a dribble handoff. They just handed Kaskaskia this game. And they've handed them a lot in this game. And now they've handed the whole game to him. 4.2 seconds, you could get a quick foul again, but that made it considerably harder. Oh my goodness. Inbound to Vassar. Foul him, and they do. 2.4 seconds on the clock. Vassar at the free throw line. Here's the deal. If I'm him, I miss the second one on purpose. The clock would run out. We'll see what happens here. Oh, my goodness. The refs handed them the game. It's not quite over. There's still 2 seconds on the clock. But
That's still such...
That's terrible.
Such a terrible... Especially...
It's
especially
a dribble handoff.
In this point of the game,
like, at that point, you don't make a call like that. At that point, you're picking sides by making a call like that. Vassar makes the first free throw. It's 87-85. They're just, that's such a ticky-tacky call when the game starts, let alone last seconds. Like, it's just, there's no reason. No reason. Vassar at the free throw line. But 2 seconds, it's a 2-point game. Let's see if he just goes for the make or if he misses on purpose. Shot up, he made it. So now Warriors need 3 points just to tie and send it to overtime. The timeout called here.
That, however, for the Warriors, is best case scenario. Makes the free throw, to 3-point game, you at least have an opportunity.
2.4 seconds. Need a miracle of a shot here. I think I go to Brandon Razor Moore.
I think I have to.
With the drive not an option anymore. Moore or Henderson are the best pure shooters on the team. I like Moore. Razor Moore's a little taller and he can rise up a little better. They tried. We were in the situation at John A. Logan earlier this season, and they Wabash Valley within one possession of knocking off the reigning national champions. But they went to Brandon Razor Moore. He didn't make it. But it was a really tough shot.
But
they
listen,
probably
yeah,
need a cleaner play to get off for him, but I think that's who you give the ball to.
In a point like this, you have to just look at it honestly.
If you're Kaskaskia, do you foul?
So, yes.
I hate that, but that's right. It's smart.
But, so what the Warriors need to do...
Don't allow him to foul.
Then that's why you call the timeout right there if you're Kaskaskia. Just listen, hey, as long, you know, if they touch the ball, you foul. Because, what, you make the first free throw, and then you have to miss the second one and get it back, and then...
Yeah, with 2 seconds.
With probably less than 2 seconds left.
At that point.
You know.
2.4 seconds right now, 88-85.
And so...
It'll be Sprinkles, Burton, Razor Moore, Henderson... Kaleem Taylor, Wabash Valley, the full length of the court to go. Right to left. 2.4 seconds. Need a 3-ball to send it to overtime. Kaskaskia playing prevent, looking like defense. Taylor on the trigger, needs help. Finds Razor Moore. Dribbles a couple times. Half court, throws up a shot. He made it! He made it! We're going to overtime! It.
That's why you go to your best player in situations like that.
We're going to overtime. Wabash Valley just got some momentum from half court.
I mean, that's unbelievable.
That's the only way to describe it. Grack basketball, ladies and gentlemen.
I mean, that is... But that's why you go to your best player in situations like that. That's why you do that.
I could... Oh. All right, we got a great view of that. We could see the whole way it was online.
Oh, it looked beautiful. It was just beautiful. But, listen, after all the horrendous calls in this ball game, missed free throws, missed opportunities.
We're still in it.
This game now has 5 more minutes left.
5 more minutes.
Now,
leave no doubt.
Whew.
Leave no doubt.
And, you know, I think Kaskaskia got a little bit ahead of themselves. You know, we've seen the chirping. We've seen it the entire game, you know, with the crowd, with the players. We've seen it. Seen 2 techs called as well in this ball game. It's been a fun game.
It has.
It has been a fun game. And
great day to be a basketball fan.
That's the thing, though. It's just a good basketball game. Like, even if you're not a Warriors fan or a Blue Devils fan, you got to be stoked. I mean, this is why we do this.
This is exactly
this is why we do this.
Why I'm a sports broadcaster. Moments like these. 5 minutes. Overtime. Who will win it? Wabash Valley still in the home whites. Kaskaskia the road. Navy Blues will have a tip here. Wabash Valley will move right to left. Kaskaskia left to right. Brandon Razor-Moore, Caleb Jenkins on the tip as we're about to get underway in overtime. This here team at the Spencer Sports Center.
Here we go.
Tip up. Up in the air. Wabash Valley wins it. Burton with the ball. Finds Sprinkles. Left corner. Jab step. Now he'll drive baseline. Reverse layup. No good, but he's fouled. He's going to the free throw line. Chance to take the lead here in the opening seconds of overtime. Another grown man move by Adrian Sprinkles.
Adrian has been so good in this ballgame so far by just driving baseline, making a spin move. He just keeps finding his way to the bucket.
Really good at driving baseline. He's really good on those reverse layup finishes. Didn't get that one, but got fouled, obviously. Free throw up. It's good. Wabash Valley takes a 1-point lead. 89-88. 4:51 left in overtime. What a game.
Well, that's all you can
gotta calm myself
that.
Down a little bit.
I know.
Sprinkles, second free throw up. It's good. Nothing but net. 90-88. Couple teams might break 100 in college basketball here.
It's crazy.
Don't see that every day. So we're running the point for Kaskaskia. Left side to Vassar. Burton on him, looking for a cutter. Vassar around the screen. We'll hand off. Slaughter with it. Back to Vassar. Right wing now. Over towards the right corner. Tolbert with it. Trying to look inside. Finds Sansford. He gets it to Jenkins. He'll go up at the block. He got it to go. We're tied back up at 90.
That beautiful high-low post, you know, passing. It's beautiful.
Taylor running the point for Wabash Valley. Calls out the play. He'll drive towards the rack. Now spin the back out. Finds Sprinkles. Tap the key. Sprinkles drives in towards the rack. Spins. Goes up the right block. He's fouled again. Sprinkles showing off the slashing ability now.
I mean, a beautiful spin move.
Jenkins, that's his second. Sprinkles will be at the free throw line. 4:10 left in overtime. Jim gets silent for Sprinkles' free throws here. First one's up. It's good. Hit the front of the rim, but got the lucky roll, fell in. Wabash Valley takes that 1-point lead right back.
See, and this is such a small lineup. You have to do a really good job of making sure that help defense is there against Jenkins.
Second one up, it's money. 92-90, 4:10 left. Tobler to bring it up. Henderson will guard him. Tolbert swings it over left side with Slaughter. Slaughter up top, Jenkins with it. He'll find Tolbert, got away with the travel. He spins in at the paint, goes up, off the back iron, no good. Rebound tipped around, Sprinkles with it. He gets it to Taylor, he'll go in transition. Kaskaskia back on defense. Taylor up top on the right wing. Around a screen from Brandon Razor-Moore. Top of the key. Driving in behind the back, he'll pull it out. 15 on the shot clock. Now Taylor goes to the rack, kicks it. Henderson, right wing. No good. Had a 3-ball opportunity. Good look. Didn't fall. Kaskaskia the other way. Vassar. Short corner. 2-point jump shot. No good. Rebound. Sanford. He'll go up. He's blocked. No. They call a foul. That's right. Got away. Got his defenders in the air. Good pump fake there by Sanford.
Beautiful pump fake. Got 3 Warriors defenders in the air. And you know, at this point, I mean, listen, their emotions are as high as everyone else is in here. So you just gotta stay calm. Just play basketball the way you know how to play. You know, stand your ground.
As of right now, as Sanford misses the first free throw, that's huge. As of right now, both teams are playing like there's still a minute left. But now that we're in overtime, there's 3 minutes, 23 seconds left. So as you mentioned, right now they're just so amped up. They're still playing like there's only 10 seconds left. And that
there's no going back from that. I mean, you get to that at one point in the game. It just stays.
Sanford made the second free throw. It's 92-91, 3:23 left in overtime. Lathe Hawksworth checks in for Sanford. He'll go to the bench. Good minutes for him. Taylor brings it up the court, right to the left for Wabash Valley. On the left side, around a screen from Moore, then Sprinkles. Driving all the way to the rack. He goes up, and it won't roll in. Rebound ends up out of bounds. It'll go Wabash Valley's way. I wasn't saying much there, but that's because I was trying to comprehend what was going on.
Trying to figure out what's going on.
Slaughter and Henderson fighting near the corner. It was a matter of time before one of them stepped out of bounds, and it was Slaughter. So Wabash Valley gets the ball, 20 seconds on the shot clock. Taylor inbound from the left corner. Looking for more. Now he needs help. He gets it to Sprinkles. Bad spacing. Almost had it tie up. Sprinkles will bring it back out. 15 on the shot clock. Sprinkles working against Hawksworth. Sprinkles into the free throw line. Now he'll hand. Burton drives in towards the rack. Finds Moore. Left corner. Three ball. Money! 95-91. Big time there. Tolbert the other way for Kaskaskia. He'll call out the play. He'll drive towards the right. Henderson on him. Vassar now inside the three-point line. Now he'll step it back out. He's over the left wing. Drives towards the corner. Now he'll drive baseline. Reverse layup, no good. Put back, no good by Jenkins. Rebound tapped around on the floor. Stays with Kaskaskia. Wabash Valley that time got their hands on the rebound. They just could not squeeze it.
Yeah, you know, it's rolling around. From my angle, I couldn't really tell who was the last one to hit it. But both teams playing hard, man. And that's why we're at this point in the ballgame.
Slaughter underneath his own basket will be on the trigger. Referee's going to talk something over here. I think the shot clock needs to be fixed. Should have been reset to 20, not 30. Right now it reads 29. I can tell you, I can assure you, that's not correct. They're going to leave it there, apparently. I don't know how you get a fresh 30 seconds. Now we're going to have a foul before the pass. It's going to be on Henderson.
I feel like at this point in the game, you know, it's getting to feel like, you know, so it's just makeup calls. You know what I'm saying? It's like, you know, there's one horrendous call one way, one horrendous call this way. And it's like...
Tolbert at the free throw line, made the first one. 95-92 is the score now. Henderson's got three fouls. Taylor with four, two for Burton. Second free throw for Tolbert's up. He made that one as well. 2-point game, 95-93. Some pressure here from Kaskaskia. Now they'll back off. Taylor will bring it up the court for Wabash Valley. 2 minutes, 15 seconds left in overtime. 2-point lead and trying to add to it are the Warriors. Taylor to the right around the screen for Burton. Flying towards the rack. He's in the short corner trying to back down Slaughter. He'll find Sprinkles. Left wing, three ball. Money! Nothing but the bottom for Sprinkles. What a game he's had. 98-93. Quickly, Slaughter the other way. Into the rack. He's rejected by Razor Moore. And Taylor's fouled. Taylor to the free throw line. Big time swing here. Sprinkles the three. Razor Moore the block. Taylor's fouled. He's going to the charity stripe. 98-93. A chance to make it 100-93 if Taylor can make both these free throws.
I've been listening to just big-time plays on both sides of the court. Adrian Sprinkles is showing, get the ball in his hands, and let's see what he can do. And then coming down here, unbelievable block as well.
Taylor's first free throw's up. It's money. 99-93, six-point lead. Chambers checks in for the first time this second half. And overtime, obviously. He checks in for Hawksworth. A little bit of a smaller lineup now. Still Jenkins in there for Kaskaskia. Taylor at the free throw line. Minute 55 left in overtime. Kaleem Taylor shot up. Off to the right. Stays 99-93. Chambers the other way to run the point for Kaskaskia. Now left side up high. It's Tolbert. Waiting for things to develop. Now he'll swing Slaughter in the left corner. Back up to Chambers. Now Tolbert. Right side up high. He'll hand off. Vassar thought about the three. Now he'll go on the dribble. Pulls up from the elbow. Too strong. Rebound to Slaughter. He'll kick it to Tolbert. He traveled, got away with it. Jab step. Jabs again. Now he'll drive into the paint. And he's fouled. He'll go to the free throw line. Sprinkles will show good sportsmanship and help him up. I think that's the difference between Wabash Fell and Kaskaskia today. Kaskaskia, a couple of technicals.
I think everyone's been John.
Well, it is basketball.
That's just how it goes.
Sprinkles now also with four fouls, so him and Taylor each have to be very careful. And they've been leading the way really here in overtime. Free throw by Tolbert's good. 99-94 is the score. Right now, if you're Wabash Valley, you'll take giving them a couple free throws each time if you can kill some clock and score on offense.
Absolutely.
Clock's on your side. And with the lead, free throws are on your side as long as you make them. Tolbert, second free throw up. Nothing but net. 99-95. Timeout, Kaskaskia. I think for the first time in a while, we are going to take a quick break here. Wabash Valley, a four-point lead, 99-95. Minute 25 left in overtime. We ain't done yet. Come back with us. We'll be back in 30 seconds.
The Faulkner Automotive in Mount Carmel, Illinois has an outstanding service department. With free pickup and delivery, we'll make sure your vehicle runs perfectly at an affordable price. Come see us today or view our service specials at stevefaulknerautomotive.com.
News Channel 15, winner of the Intercollegiate Broadcasting System Award for the nation's best community college TV station.
Zach Reynolds, Austin Harrelson at the Spencer Sports Center on 89.1 The Bash and News Channel 15 YouTube, the Warrior Sports Network. We're in overtime here at the Spencer Sports Center after Brandon Razor Moore at the end of regulation. Half-court shot, and it was true. Half-court over the logo. Money to send us to overtime. Now Wabash Valley with a four-point lead, 99-95, with a minute 25 left in overtime number one. Taylor will bring it up the court. Wabash Valley with the ball after the timeout. Taylor guarded by Slaughter. Leaking towards the left side. Now he'll dribble right around a couple of screens. Picked up by Vassar. Up high right side, 15 on the shot clock. Taylor drives towards the paint. Goes around the paint, throws it away, and yep, Tolbert stepped out of bounds. He sure did. Saw that, they almost didn't call it. Wabash Valley catches a break there.
Yeah, that's a big break for Wabash now. Now, you know, new shot clock.
20 on the shot clock, a minute and 5 on the game clock, 99-95 still. Wabash Valley with the lead. Kaleem Taylor will be on the trigger underneath and just to the left of his own basket. Taylor looking. Asking for help, throws it up to Burton. Now Henderson over the logo, they'll run some offense. Henderson calls for a screen. He'll go right around it from Sprinkles. Gets cut off, Jenkins is there. Nice pass, extra pass, left corner. Kaleem Taylor, three ball, no good. Rebound knocked around. Wabash Valley comes away with it, it's Sprinkles. Razor Moore saved it inbounds to him. Throws it to Henderson now, under a minute. Taylor's fouled in the corner by Jenkins. 41.9 seconds left in a free throw game. Wabash Valley with a 4-point lead trying to add to it. Kaleem Taylor, one of the better free throw shooters on the team, going to the line.
I mean, he's been the guy that they've gone to a lot in this ball game.
Taylor's free throw's up. Off the back iron, good.
It got real quiet here in this gym.
Real quiet. Needs to make the second one. 4-point game, trying to extend it to an even 5-point game. Not even, but a round number.
An odd.
Taylor makes the second one. 100-95, 41.9 seconds. Kaskaskia going left to right. Tolbert on the left wing, swings over, right wing. Vassar wide open, three ball. Too strong, rebound to Henderson. Henderson's foul, he'll go to the line. Lucas Henderson might be the smallest guy on the court, and he boxed out, and he fought for that rebound. He's also a very good free throw shooter. He needs a couple here. Could be the dagger.
Man. man.
What a game.
What a game indeed. I mean, so many things, you know, adversity-wise for this Warriors team. They were able to adapt, you know. They didn't let the refs win this game. They didn't stop. They didn't stop them from winning, or, you know, at least putting themselves in a position to where you can't be mad right now.
Lucas, Cash Henderson at the free throw line. Shot up. It's Cash Money. 101-95.
Defensively, for the Warriors, do not foul.
Free throw up. $2 at the free throw line for Cash Henderson. 102-95. Under 30 seconds left. Slaughter driving to the rack. Spins outside the right block. He'd go up with the left hand. It falls in. And Kaskaskia going to take a timeout. They got a lot of them.
Yeah, no, I mean, at this point.
Hit your free throws. It's Wabash Valley's game.
That's the big thing here is making sure you hit your free throws. You know, I mean, listen, this is by no means this Kaskaskia team. Let's look at the scoring chart here. I mean, you got three guys, 20-point games, another with 18. This team is. This Kaskaskia team's got a lot of talent.
They're 14-2 for a reason. They're really good. Really good team.
And, you know, this Warriors team, though, they just play such good team basketball. You know, it's not, you know, ISO ball all the time. You know, granted, in certain situations, you want ISO ball. You want, let's say, like a Brandon Razor Moore with the ball in his hands, or, you know, a Kaleem Taylor, you know, driving to the basket. You know, give him space. That's what you want. But, you know, this team's getting open shots. Adrian Sprinkles has had himself a good game. Look at Daniel Robinson. He's had himself a terrific game. McGowan, you know, everybody's doing, you know, contributing so much. And so, you know, I give a lot of props to this Warriors team because we talked at halftime, like, how's this team going to adapt? This team scored 35 points in the first half, and they are now at 102. I didn't think that they could have gotten that much better on offense, but apparently they did.
They did.
You look at the Blue Devils, they scored 41 in the first half, and now they're at 97.
19.7 seconds left, but, well, I think the end of regulation just about proved anything can happen in basketball. So, still a lot of time here. Wabash Valley got to get a clean inbound off, full court pressure from Kaskaskia. Four lengths of the court to go. Taylor on the trigger. Can run the baseline, throws it in, and Burton comes away with it. He's fouled. He'll go to the free throw line. Risky there, almost knocked away, but Burton corralled it.
I see what Taylor was looking for here, but he's putting himself in a bad situation, throwing right under the goal. You don't have a lot of, you know, air time, or you can't, yeah, you know, lob it or anything. Henderson's wide open, but, you know, just got to be a little bit safer. Luckily, the ball goes into Burton's hands, you couldn't have asked for a better basketball game.
I believe Slaughter just fouled out, so in comes a new player for Kaskaskia. Burton's free throws up, it's money. That is Martin Garza. Sorry for the technical difficulties back here. Burton took the ball away. The free throw was missed. Burton got the rebound. Wabash Valley with the win in overtime.
What a win. What a game.
They came back. They were down by 10 at multiple points in the second half. They came back within one multiple times. Sometimes the referee's whistle didn't go their way. It took a Brandon Razor Moore half-court shot at the buzzer to send us to overtime. And then Adrian Sprinkles and Kaleem Taylor and the free throws took over in overtime. Wabash Valley wins 103-97.
I mean, you couldn't have asked for a better ball game, and you couldn't have asked for this Warriors team to overcome so much adversity. So props to this Warriors team, but a big-time props for Terrence McGee. Going into halftime, you know, they ended up scoring 70 more points in the second half. You know, that's just, you know, how it goes. So shout out Terrence McGee, because it's got a different vibe here with Terrence McGee coming in and being the head coach of this basketball team.
What a day to be a Warrior. What a day to be a basketball fan. Wabash Valley wins 103-97. Half court buzzer beater, free throw, defense, lots of offense. Couldn't ask for anything else.
No, absolutely not. I'm ready for the next men's game.
Wabash Valley improves to 10-3 now on the year. Very, very good season. Yep. So far to start, they still got a lot of crack play to go. But it's looking good right now. Kaskaskia, give them credit too. Very good team in their own right. Played it all the way to the end. They fall to 14-3. Oh, no. 14-3. They're very, very good.
That's...
I expect these two teams to meet somewhere down the line for a big deal in the conference when we get down to the end of it. But Wabash Valley improves to 10-3. They win 103-97 in overtime with the heroics. For all of us helping us out here on 89.1 The Bash and News Channel 15, YouTube, the Warrior Sports Network. For Austin Harrelson, I'm Zach Reynolds. Great day to be a Warrior. Great day to be a basketball fan. Wabash Valley wins. We'll see you next time. Thank you.